These are the days that I felt when my this by saying, I know that all of you who are here, that none of you are at the last show that we just played, but you're probably going to hear some of the same songs if you were. Because, you know, we can't leave anybody out. Like this one, for example.
Thank you. seen through this face a thousand times. I wish I could stand to watch it change. Again, I feel like I'm weaker than I have ever been. You're asking why I'm so different.
Oh! It's kind of quiet. Is it a little quiet here? Yeah. Yeah, okay, we'll play M. Wanna play M?
I know you're
Christina, you wanna sing this one?
Christina's gonna sing with us again, but she doesn't look like she wants to very much. I'm just kidding. Christina Hill is the female vocalist who I duet with on the recording. Yeah, we want to make this like a storyteller's. Do you guys know what the song is about? Do you guys want me to tell you what the song's about? Does anyone care? For real? It's on the message board. Actually, the message board is our message board for our website is run by this guy Adrian from California, and he's here tonight. So he flew out and shit, which is awesome. And at the show before this, there were two people here from Japan who flew here. They're still here? There they are, yes! That's awesome. There's people here from Germany? Wow, there were two kids here from Germany. Impressive. And there were some people here from New Jersey. So anyway, this song is about my cousin Emily. That's what everyone calls her M, but so that's what it stands for. And it's just about how when she was when my aunt was pregnant with her, her dad decided that he didn't want to be her dad and he didn't want to be married to my aunt anymore, so he just up and left. And it was just about pretty much how like amazing of a person she is, and how, you know, I would never want to be him because he's a dick, but I would give anything if I could, like, you know, have that role as like a father for her, because, you know, so that's good. So that's what it's about. So here it is. your ass. Nothing. He didn't say nothing. This song's for him, so I'll shut up.
Thank you.
storytellers. Just, I don't understand.
I'd like to hear this story.
Well, this song is just about, this song is human drama, by the way. It's on our first days of skate. And it's pretty much just about, like, you know, standing up for what you believe in as far as, I mean, anything, like politics and just your personal beliefs, because, you know, I don't know. What's a good anecdote for this? When did I write the lyrics for this? I think it was in the car on the way to the studio, but it was right after I went to a convention at Madison Square Garden for Ralph Nader. And it just kind of like, and Bill Murray was up on stage talking, and he said something that was just like, that just made me think about just how, I don't know, lots of people, like, some of my beliefs aren't necessarily mainstream, and so lots of people like to think that therefore they're not valid. So it's just about, you know, it doesn't matter what people say because their beliefs aren't necessarily valid either. I guess, you know, whatever, I don't fucking know. It's just, anyhow, this is a song. Thank you.
I'll take this second to thank Andrew from Millie Ram Records. For I don't know where he is. He helped us out. He helped us out a great deal. So is he still here?
I'm sure he's still here somewhere.
What? He's doing the merch, huh?
He's the best. He managed to scrounge up 70 of our out of print 7 inches for the tonight's show,
which is cool. And Poulin as well. Poulin came up from Virginia.
Yeah. Where he's working for PETA.
Yeah, he's working for PETA.
You could ask him about that if you
want. Yeah. I want to thank him. He helped us a lot, too. I mean, there's so many people that helped us so much that you could stand here for an hour.
Definitely. So this song is for them. And there's John Cafaro, of course.
And John Cafaro.
Who's countless hours of amusement on long van rides does not go unnoticed.
And Dan, and Rob, and Matt, and
Al.
And Al, and
PJ.
And PJ.
And oh, so you said you weren't gonna name everybody, now here you go.
I'm sorry, okay, I'll stop. But
we're
everybody,
sorry for that,
you know who you are, thank you. Fine, oh yeah.
Thank you.
Into.
We had a set list, but it all fell apart when we had to split the show into two things.
I'm out.
nice. We're gonna play a song now, and what usually happens when we play this song is that everyone attacks us, which is fine. But just be careful about all this stuff over here, because the last show we played, we actually didn't even play the whole song, because it was pretty much just...
Yeah, it just kind of stopped.
Yeah. So it'd be cool to finish it this time.
Watch your back!
So watch yourselves. Check yourself. Thank you. Hey, thanks.
Check one.
One time we played this song and Steve broke somebody's finger, but I'm not naming any name. I'm not naming anybody's names except for Steve. Okay.
We have two more songs, right?
These are our last two
our
songs.
Last two songs.
Ever?
Hold on.
Two, possibly three? I don't know. I think. What are we playing?
Since this is the last one, I just want to say I love you guys.
Yeah, I didn't really say anything to you guys either.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't. But I guess I kind of feel like it goes, I don't have to say much, but you guys know this band meant everything to me, and it still does, even though it's over, but... I don't know. Thank you all for everything.
Thanks. I'm just gonna say real quick, unless, do you wanna go first? Go ahead.
You're the lead singer, so you should go last.
Okay.
Gosh, where do I start? How long have we been doing this?
10 years.
10 years.
The four of us have been playing together.
10 years. Rich lives on the same street as me and I.
Yeah, we grew up together. It was cute.
There's one thing though.
Uh-oh.
There's one thing about
I don't know
Rich.
What you're gonna. What do you mean? One thing about Rich.
Rich was always the coolest guy because he could play any Metallica solo. I wanted to be a good guitar player like Rich. This guy's been playing since he like came out of the womb. He doesn't know that, but I always wanted to be Rich when we were little.
Oh, really?
And Brian.
Aww.
Brian.
I know what you're gonna tell me.
Brian was the only one of Mike's friends who was nice to me in high school. I was homesick one day, and Brian came over after school with Mike, and they watched Japanese animation movies.
Because we were cool.
That's right. Brian was nice, unlike the others. And and then he let me borrow his Nintendo 64 to play Star Fox. Is that what it was?
That's how nice Super Nintendo.
Super Nintendo.
That's how old it was.
Yeah. So I always looked up to Bri for that. Okay, now my brother, on the other hand, no, I always looked up to him too. Mike is a kick-ass drummer. And he taught himself everything. Never took a lesson a day in his life. That just goes to show you. But not only that, on a personal level, he always seemed to get through things that were tough and come out okay on the other side. You know what I mean? And that's my bro. So I love these guys. Thank you for 10 years, the three of you.
Word.
Okay, my turn. I was 15 when I met Mike Jones in my biology class in high school. And he gave me a fake plastic fly. And I drew a picture on the paper bag cover on his biology book. And then we were friends. And then one day we said we were going to start a band. I said I sing, and Mike said I play the drums. And we both kind of did, but not really. So... Yeah, pretty much. So we went over at Mike's house one day, and Mike's like, I know this guy lives on my street, he plays guitar. So we called up Rich. We came over, we started jamming, and we were terrible.
Terrible. And, terrible.
Yeah, terrible. And then, but we were playing, you know, like Metallica songs and stuff, because Rich could play Metallica songs. And Steve Jones was, you know, is Mike's brother, and Steve was a guitar player, and we kind of recruited him to play bass for a demo we were going to record of 5 songs, which I hope nobody's ever heard. And it's even before that, actually. It's old school. Right. There's a Green Day cover on there. And but I don't know, you know, it's been like, I was 15 then, I'm 25 now. And it's been like the only, like, you know, I'm really bad with talking, by the way. For like the past 10 years, this has been the only like steady, like amazingly like wonderful thing in my life that I always, you know, look forward to doing, playing music and playing with these guys. So I love you guys, and thanks. That's it. This song's called, this song's called 23. Rich has to tune his guitar real quick. So I just want to say also, this song's interesting because it's about like friendships, you know, and how sometimes they just end for no reason, I guess. And I'm lucky to have these four guys, these three guys. Sorry, I was including myself because I do like myself a little bit, not that much. And you know, I've been lucky to have these three guys as friends for the past 10 years, you know, always. This song is actually about another friend of mine who I'm not friends with anymore, interestingly enough. I wrote the song when we stopped being friends, and then we started being friends again, and now we're not friends anymore again, so. But, you know, so that stuff just kind of happens, and I'm happy to say, and I hope that even though we're not playing music anymore, well, you know, that we're still always friends, so. 23. Don't know why it's called 23, though.
It's a good number. Yeah, it's a nice number.
What do you call a fish with no eyes?
Something inside.
head of my crew arrived then. I wish I could care to forget the things that you said. Thank you. Thanks for being here. Have a safe drive home, okay?